إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره نعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما أما بعد فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها فإن كل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار وإنما توعدون لآت وما أنتم بمعجزين. Greet you all with the greeting of Islam. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. I'd like to welcome you all for continuation of our series reviewing the book Mukhtasar Minhaj Al-Qasidin Imam Ibn Qudam Al-Maqdisi Rahmatullah Alayh. This is a book of the methodology of the seekers, and what we're doing here is that we, after the book been translated, we try to compare the translation to the Arabic version and make sure that nothing is missing before we, inshallah, by the will of Allah, publish the book. And this will be the 12th class tonight for the reviewing. Tonight we still have a chapter related to the Azkar, the remembrance of Allah, and certain duties in different times and different occasions. And it talks about that as-salik li tariq al-akhira, the seeker of the hereafter, he have to be one of the six conditions. Is this what you have there? What is the word say stop? What does
Hassan al-Basri?
Okay. What does it say? Last thing that we were discussing, that the seeker of the hereafter, after he finished the tahajjud prayer at night, let him seeking Allah's forgiveness. And it been narrated that Ibn Umar used to do so. You don't have any signs there?
Yes, it says start. It says start.
Okay. What does it say after this?
Hassan al-Basri said, I have not found any act of worship to be harder than performing Salah at night.
Okay, after this?
It said,
Thank you. Where is your son when the last time that you read your son?
Part 2, I read that and just stopped it.
Chapter concerning different duties at different times and different conditions.
Okay, the last thing I read was
page number 12 or 11, is it?
Yeah, okay.
Okay.
Yeah, right here is where I start.
Okay. We went after you for one class. The fourth duty, okay. So we need to go to until sixth duty. And I only reported that the wise messenger said to him, Fatima, Abu Huraira, the Muslim reports that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam went to bed, then when wakes up the Hajjud, he says the dua, okay, remember Allah the faith, okay, so where is the six? Okay, let's see, is this the sixth duty? Will you read, please?
Bismillah, alhamdulillah, wa salatu wa salam ala rasulillah. The sixth duty is at the time of suhoor. Allah the Exalted says in Surah Al-Dhariyat, verse number 18, of which the meaning is, and at the time of suhoor, they seek forgiveness. And it has been narrated in a hadith, truly reciting during the last part of the night is witness, Muslim. A tawus came to a man during the time of suhoor and
Sahar, not suhoor. I give you a pen of it.
Is that it? Okay. Sahar.
Yeah.
Sahar, dawn.
Before dawn.
Okay. Sahar.
A man came to tawus
during the time of Sahar and told him, they are sleeping. So he said, I do not think that anyone slept at the time of Sahar. So if the seeker finishes his salah during the time of Sahar, then he should seek Allah's forgiveness. And it has been reported that Ibn Umar radiallahu anhu used to do this.
Okay.
New section on the excellence of tahajjud and the causes which make it easy. Allah the Exalted says in Surah Al-Sajda.
Okay. So he jumped two pages. Wow. Okay, we have a chapter here, so you don't have this there.
No.
It say chapter concerning different duties according different condition and times. A seeker of the hereafter, he have to be one of the six condition. He have to be a abid, worshipper, or a alim, a scholar, or muta'alliman, student, or a wali, or a person who has a business, or a person who drowned in the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and busy with it at all the time.
Thank you.
So this is all right. Say as for the first one, which is the عابد, that mean people who approach in the hereafter, he's going to be one of the six people. That a person who worship in Allah, alright, that mean a person who fulfill duties of Islam but is not knowledgeable. A second person who be a scholar. A third person, he may be to be a student. A fourth person, or a person can be a wali of Allah, a friend of Allah, or a person who adopt a occupation, or a person who deep down in the love of Allah. So this is six kind of people. The first type of people, okay, is the abid, and the person who is totally devoted and so busy and occupied in worshiping Allah. And this person is supposed to remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with the different dhikrs that we mentioned before. Those who worship Allah among the Salaf, it used to be different. Some of them, they used to spend most of their time in recitation of the Quran, to such a degree they used to finish the whole Quran in one day. Or sometimes they may finish two Quran in one day or three times in one day. Some of them they used to glorify the name of Allah. Some of them they used to make a lot of prayer. And some of them they used to do a lot of tawaf. He's talking about the one of the types of the people. Okay? That the people in general are one of these six. He be a student, he be a scholar, he be a worshiper, a business person, okay, that have occupation. So he describing how each person out of this people spend his time. He says the worshiper that he devoted totally to the worship of Allah, that some of them, they used to be reading Quran day and night, to such a degree that some of them, they used to finish the Quran once or twice, and sometimes up to three times a day, finish the whole Quran from cover to cover. Alright? So you can imagine, you understand, there is almost no time to sleep. Because if you have 24 hours in the day, and even if you sleep only 5 hours, okay, give another 2-3 hours between making salah, using bathroom, making wudu. So this is 8 hours. So what is left is what? 16 hours? Mm-hmm. 16 hours though, and you want to finish 30 juz of the Quran. So for somebody to be finished even one time, this is, to me, is, I don't know how to can. I barely finish it one time in a month. Astaghfirullah. But he says some of them, they used to occupy their time in the glorification of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, making tasbih. Okay. Some of them, they used to be making too much salah during the day, and some of them, they used to do a lot of tawaf around the Kaaba. So for somebody like this, which the best for him to spend his time, you have to know that the recitation of the Quran in salah, standing up with reflection, this will be combining all this kind of ibadah. But perhaps it became so hard on the person. So it's time that it's better for you to change and shift between different things. The purpose behind all the duties and the remembrance is elevation of the iman and purification of the heart. So a person who's seeking the hereafter, he has to reflect and think which one really has more impact on his heart, without making him restless, and he can keep with it. So if you felt that you that you incline towards more recitation of the Quran, and this is helping your iman and elevating your feeling about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the taqwa. So stick with Quran. If you feel that tawaf is more good, you understand, helping you, do more tawaf. But the main thing, keep with such thing as long you don't feel that you get exhausted, you don't like it, you don't care for it anymore. Abu Sulaiman, rahmatullah alayh, is saying, if you found the presence and the focusing of your heart in standing up, so don't go to ruku', keep standing and keep reciting. Okay? So if you found it more tranquility in the ruku', so spend more time in the ruku', do not rush and raise your head. Alright? Now, as for the second type of person who seeking the hereafter, he can be a scholar, and the people will benefit from his knowledge and his fatwa, because he's teaching, he's making books, he's reminding the people. So how is this person going to make his duties during the day? This is different from the abid, the person who worshiping, because the scholar, he need more to keep up with the information and keep reading and making books for others to benefit. So he spend more time in this. This will be more rewarded after he fulfilled the basic duty. So he made your fard salah, the 5-time prayers. So instead engage in optional prayers, this will be more beneficial. Why? Because you benefit in yourself and you're going to benefit others. But keeping making salah, you only gaining reward for yourself. So it said for the scholar will be better for him to study and to teach, because this will be beneficial for the others. And when we're talking about knowledge, we're talking about the knowledge that which is make you seek the hereafter more and make you try to be guided towards the akhirah. It is advised that the scholar to divide his time. That because for you to sit and study day and night, it needs a lot of patience, and maybe will be too much in your heart or yourself. Therefore, we advise that the person will specialize the morning time after the sun rise to be in the remembrance of Allah. Then after the sun rise, until the time of Duha, that he will spend it in teaching the people. If he did not have students in that time, so he will direct this time in tafakkur and tadabbur, reflection. Okay? Reflection on the knowledge and purification of the heart after he had finished his zikr. And before he start to get worried about the dunya business. Because reflection and purifying the heart, this is very important before you start to get engaged in the worldly affair. And he will delay the time of writing and combining books to the time during the day until the time of Asr. And not to stop unless he have to eat or that he have to renew his wudu or that he may need to take a nap. Then he will spend the time after this in hearing what he had put together. That means one of the students will read and he will hear what he wrote and to make sure that the thing is correct. Then after this, he will get busy before sunset, okay, with the istighfar, seeking Allah's forgiveness and glorification. So that means he will go between action with the tongue, and action with the heart, and action with the eye and the hand by writing, and also action and ibadah by listening, and action by the eye and the hand in copying, and he should avoid writing after Asr because it may be hurtful for his eyes. As for his time during the night, he should divide it like Imam Shafi'i rahmatullahi alayhi. Imam Shafi'i, may Allah send mercy in his soul, he used to divide the night to 3 parts. The first part is for writing, the second part for prayer, and the third part for sleeping. During the summer, maybe he's not able to do so. Perhaps he will have more sleep during the day. Now we go to the other type of people which can be student of knowledge. If this student of knowledge is one of the seeker of the hereafter, so the best thing for him to do is to learn and to study. And this will be better for him than making dhikr an optional. And the ruling for the student, same thing is the ruling for the scholar concerning the duties that he need to do. But he should spend most of his time in benefiting from the scholar and taking footnote and writing. When is the scholar or his teacher is busy with putting books together? But if he one of the regular people, he's supposed to attend the halaqa or of dhikr or ilm. That means if he's not an educated person and he's not a student, he should sit with the people when he's gathering for tafsir or remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This will be more beneficial for him than him sitting, making optional prayer and making dhikr. The fourth person of those people who seeking the hereafter can be Iwali, as example, or Al-Wali. Al-Wali, that means like the Imam, or the Khalifa, or the person in charge of the affairs of the Muslim, or the judge, okay? Or the person who in charge of the affairs of the Muslims, so for him to spend his time serving the Muslims and making sure that their affairs run according to the Sharia, this will be much rewarded for him than occupying himself with the remembrance of Allah. Because his ibadah, it will benefit others. Okay? So the judge when he go, because otherwise the people would be fighting and arguing, disputing, and maybe even killing themselves. So instead of him sitting and making dhikr and reciting Quran, now it is better for him to spend his time serving the Muslim community. And since that means, because the benefit of this is not only for himself, okay, but it will help others, members of the community. So during the day, he should only focus about the obligatory acts of Islam, then he will utilize the rest of the time to what? Benefiting the Muslims. And he will be satisfied with the Qiyam al-Layl. Okay? So he's saying that the people, everybody have to see what is his occupation. Are you a scholar? Or you're studying? Or are you a judge? Okay? So everybody have to see what how he can utilize his time in the best way. As for the person who has occupation, and he's in need to earn money for himself or for his family, we could not obligate him and tell him, spend your time in the ibadah. But he will spend his time in earning the halal dime, dollar, and in the same time he can be remembering Allah while he's doing his work. So when he made sufficient for his day, for him and his family, he should stop and go take care of his family and his ibadah to Allah. The sixth person, a person who's deeply down in the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This person, his duty or wazifa, after fulfilling the obligatory acts, is making the heart presence in the ibadah of Allah. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is saying that most dearer deed to Allah, the one that you do it continuously, even if it's little. Okay? So he's saying that the person have to reflect too much on Allah, and even if his dhikr is not a lot, but as long as he keep it in constant and always in certain times, this will be acceptable, because it's still dear to Allah that you do little, but you continue with it in different times. Now we come back again to the section that you have here. So all this is missing, and I didn't read it before, so I have a lousy translation, but I think he catches something out of it. So all this is missing. You can make a mark there that right to page number 58 and 59 are missing from the Arabic version. Excuse me?
What was number 59?
The name of the person? The name of the person who's deep in love with Allah. That means he's not a scholar. He's not a student of knowledge. He's not a businessman. He's not to understand any of this. A person that basically give his life to Allah and all what he needs, he understands, sit and reflect on Allah day and night. Because some people, they get a check from the government, or that they inherit a lot of money from their parents when they die. Some people, they have money. They don't have to work. And they are not up to study business and things like this, but he really concerned about, you understand, seeking the hereafter and be in love with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So the Shaykh rahmatullah alayhi say, for him to make his heart to always, first he have to fulfill all the duties. So there is nothing called love of Allah or being a scholar or being a student on the expenses or the basics. You have to make the five-time prayers, you have to fast Ramadan, you have to do the basics of Islam. Now what to do after this? Now this is the addition that he's saying. So everybody of these six people have to fulfill the basic duties first. A person, as example, could not neglect his children, okay, and keep go begging the people because they say, I'm in love of Allah, or that I'm trying to seek knowledge. No, you still, you have to fulfill your duties before getting, being a scholar or being a student or be all these things. You need to learn the basic of your deen. Now, if you want to be a scholar or you need to understand to have more, now after fulfilling the basic obligation from salah, having food for your children, things like this. Okay? So did he say page number 58 and 59 missing from the Arabic? Yeah. And now we come to the chapter, the end of this chapter, inshallah. Chapter concerning the prayer.
Yeah, on the excellence of tahajjud and the causes which make it easy. Allah the Exalted says in Surah Tasajjuda, verse number 16, of which the meaning is, they keep their sides aloof from their bed. And the Prophet of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, I advise you with salah at night, for truly it is the norm of the righteous before you, and it is a mean of coming close to your Lord and getting His forgiveness for your evil deeds and a prevention from sin, or Tirmidhi. Al-Hasan al-Basri said, I have not found any act of worship to be harder than performing salah during the night. It was said to him, what is it with those who make tahajjud that they have the most handsome faces? He said, it is because they have been secluded with the most gracious, and thus he adorned them with his light. And you should know that performing salah during the night is hard, except for he who has been enabled to get up by following the means which make that easy. And these are of two types, external and internal. As for the external means, they include not eating too much.
So it's telling you now about what things is going to help you to make Qiyam al-Layl. Get up like 3-4 o'clock in the morning, or 4 o'clock will be late. Get up there like 3:30, understand, and make a prayer, or 2 o'clock, okay, and make a prayer. It's not an easy job. So he's telling you about the certain things that you have to do it outward and inward also. That it will help you to stand up in the prayer during the night. This is optional prayer now. Yes.
As for the external means, they include not eating too much. Some people used to say, O companions of the seeker, do not eat too much, for then you will drink too much, and thus sleep too much, and lose much. And the external means, include not tiring oneself out during the day by heavy work, and not leaving off taking qailula during the daytime.
You need to make a mark there, right? Nap, whatever. That qailula is supposed to be in English so that people can know.
We use it. Spanish word siesta.
Okay. We're not going to translate in Spanish. Siesta.
Okay. During the daytime, but truly it helps in standing during the night. Also, avoiding the sin is an external mean. At-Tawri said, I was prevented from tahajjud for 5 months because of a sin that I committed.
SubhanAllah.
And as for the internal means, they include having a heart free from all ill towards every Muslim and empty of every type of bid'ah, turning away from what is extra in this world, having a strong fear which is attached to the heart, and having an expectation of a short life, and knowing the benefits of salah during the night. And the best of causes for that is the love of Allah and strength of iman that he has conversing with his Lord, and that he is with him and watching him, so his conversing with him should cause him to lengthen his salah. Abu Sulaiman Zarani said, the people of the night take more pleasure in their nights than the people of vanity take in their vanities. And what is not for the night, I would not, if was it not for the night, I would not have loved to remain in this world. And Muslim reports in his Sahih that the Prophet of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, truly there is an hour during the night which no Muslim servant catches asking Allah for good therein, except that he gives him that, and this is so every night. And spending the night awake is of several levels. The first is to spend the whole night awake, and this was done by a group of the Salaf. The second is to stand for half of it, and this was also reported from a group of the Salaf. And the best way of doing this is to sleep for the first third of the night and the last sixth. The third level is to stand for one third of the night, and it is proper that he sleep the first half and the last sixth. And this is the standing of Dawood alayhi salam, and it is reported in the two Sahih. The most beloved salah to Allah is the salah of Dawood alayhi salam. He used to sleep for one half of the night and then stand for a third and sleep the remaining sixth. And sleeping during the last part of the night is good, as it removes the signs of tiredness from the face and lessens any yellowness. The fourth level is to stand for one-sixth or one-fifth of the night, and the best course in that is that it be in the middle of the night. And it has been said it should be the last sixth of the night, so that's an alternate opinion. The fifth level is that he not preserve any particular timing, for preserving that is hard, and there are two methods for this. The first, that he stand during the first part of the night until sleep overtakes him, and then sleep. Then when he wakes up, he should stand until sleep overtakes him again, and so forth. And this takes immense effort and struggle, and has been mentioned for a group of the Salaf. And Anas radiyallahu anhu has been reported in the two Sahih as saying, we did not wish to see Allah's Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam performing salah during the night, except that we saw, and we did not wish to see him sleeping except that we saw him sleeping. And Umar radiyallahu anhu used to perform salah during whatever portion of the night Allah willed. And when the last part of the night came, he would wake up his family saying, Salah, Salah. And Dahak said, I have met people who were too shy in front of Allah to lie down for long. The second method is that he sleep for the first part of the night. Then, when he has taken his portion of sleep and wakes up, he stands for the rest. Sufyan al-Thawri said, it is at first sleep, and then when I wake up, I do not rest. That is, he would not sleep again. The sixth level is that he stand for the period of four rak'ah or two rak'ah. And Abu Dawood reports that Allah's Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, whoever wakes up during the night and wakes up his family, and they perform together two rak'ah of salah, then they are written as amongst the men and women who remember Allah much that night. So these are the methods of dividing up the night. So the seeker should so choose for himself whatever is easy for him. And if getting up during the middle of the night is hard upon him, he should not miss out on busying himself between Maghrib and Isha. And at the time of Sahur, so as to busy himself during the two ends of the night. And this is a seventh level. As for the one upon whom performing wudu is hard at night and performing salah is heavy upon him, then he should sit facing the Qibla and make zikr and dua as much as possible. And if he does not sit, then he should make dua while lying down. And whoever has a norm of standing during the night but is overtaken by sleep and misses that, then he should make up for that during the time of dua, as has been mentioned. Then he should make up for that during the time of duha, as has been mentioned in a hadith. And the one who normally stands during the night should beware of leaving that. For it has been reported in the two Sahih that Allah's Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam said to Abdullah ibn Amr,
Abdullah ibn Amr.
Mm-hmm. Do not be like so and so, for he used to stand at night and left off standing at night. New section?
Yeah.
Okay, new section. What
do you mean by so and so?
Don't want. So and so, without mentioning name, like I say, don't be like so and so. You don't have to expose him, okay? that don't be like a person who used to make the prayer at night and they stop making it.
Section on the differences of people in regards to the duties. You should know that the traveler upon the path of the hereafter does not escape from being in one of the six situations. Either he must be one devoted to worship, an island.
Hold it. What is this? This is seem what this what is was missing.
Yeah, it's in the wrong place.
Okay.
Yeah, this is it.
Okay, how much?
It's tough here. Yeah.
So this is what is missing.
The second, the third, the fourth, the fifth, and the sixth. Yeah. Read up in class.
All right, so we're going to stop here, inshallah, and we can pick it up for next time.
Before you stop, what was the second thing with to spend the night awake? What was number two after that? After we first started the different levels.
The one that stands half of the night?
Okay, yes, that was it.
All right. سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك نشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت نستغفرك ونتوب إليك إن الله نزلت.
So right here missing. This is the missing.
The missing part. We're going to read it inshallah at the school.
So you don't have another class on that tomorrow.
Next year inshallah.
Next year, come on, Sheikh. Cause I was thinking we just haven't come Tuesday and Thursday.
Okay, inshallah. What's tomorrow? Sunday.
Yeah.
Inshallah, to my best. Make sure you be here, huh?
I'll be here.
Don't be like so and so.
Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد